Hi there. I'm Matt with K15T, and let's talk about how you can use Confluence databases to manage your team's content creation process. This is something we do a lot at K15T because we create a lot of content that we like to share with you. And we assemble a pretty big backlog of content ideas that we define in a Confluence database. Our mission at K15T is to enable every team to share their knowledge freely, so we're always creating content to do just that. But there's important details about each of those pieces of content, like, for example, what should it be? Should it be a blog post? Should it be an article, long video, short video? And this process begins with a new entry in our database where people write down things like, what are the main ideas? What's a summary? What's the priority of this particular piece of content? When was it added to the backlog? Now, we've set up some default values here because some of these fields don't often need to be changed, like the priority. It's set to medium by default, and only people like me will bump it up to high because we think our content is more important. Also, the author is kept at a default state because often Maggie is the one who creates these, but again, I could update this value if it makes sense. Speaking of content, if you are looking for ways to improve the quality of your content in Confluence, maybe check out K15T's app Scroll Content Quality, which is made for checking your content to make sure it's high quality. Okay, back to it. As we pick up the content idea, begin working on it, and move all the way to the completion of the content creation process, we update the page status in Confluence. This helps anybody who's working on the content directly to see what's coming up next and what the current status is, and it helps anyone on the team who's looking at the full database also see the status in our full process. And we can use different views to get another look at that progress, like looking at the board view of a database to see, based on the type of content, what's being worked on and when. There are also certain image files that we create as part of our content projects, like a thumbnail or a share image. We use an image field to attach the latest version of that image so that it's really visible on the database and accessible to anybody who might need it at any time in the process. And because our content is designed to be reused internally, it's fairly often that someone is making a new piece of content that relates to something that we already made. Like when I'm making a video about an article that we already wrote, or I need some footage from a video we made a few months back. So we can quickly skim through the database view to find completed projects with the resources we need, navigate to the links so that we can jump into Google Drive or wherever and find those resources because they're just easier to find when they're organized in a database. Now, this is just content management in Confluence databases. There is so much more you can do with Confluence. So jump into another video in the series as we continue to explore how to use Confluence to share what you do.